Children came in the middle of the roar. Children came in the middle of the roar. To the right, to the left, just keep in the middle of the roar. Children came in the middle of the roar. Children came in the middle of the roar. Just keep in the middle of the road, in the middle of the road, in the middle of the road.
I hear those angels calling
the middle of the road.
Keep in the middle of the road,
in the middle of the road.
There's a great thing back in the
keep in the middle of the road, keep
in the middle of the road.
I can see there's standing by the big white gate. We must travel along before it gets too late.
Was it then no use for us sit on the road?
Just keep in the middle of the road. The children keep in the middle of the road. Children keep in the middle of the road. To the right, to the left, just keep in the middle of the road. In the middle of the road, in the middle of the road.
Before we left this place to Lilongwe. We were here and we were used to sit there, and Brother Nkosi was teaching us that class. So I think you know her, but for the sake of those, maybe you cannot remember her. Let me just humbly ask you, my wife, to stand so that people can see her.
Jesus is coming again. Amen.
Yeah, so I would like to welcome you. And I'm very, very happy because these people now, they will know that this man is a married man. He's not only the pastor, but he is talking with authority. Not only that he is a pastor, but because he is married. So I think these people from now, they will learn to respect me. You're thinking that I'm single. Thanks so much. I would like to welcome you to our lesson for tonight. We have this lesson. We would like to discuss about issues regarding our finances, personal finances. This is the lesson for tonight. So I would like to welcome you in a special way. My brother, okay. I would like to welcome you in a special way to this lesson. Personal finances. When we are talking about personal finance, it is the financial management which a family or an individual can decide how they can perform their budget, how they can save their money, how they can spend. We would like to talk about all those things today. We are also going to look into our income. How do we raise our funds for our families? So we will look into all those things tonight. What is the source of family income? That should also be noted to each one of us. We should not forget that God put man in the Garden of Eden to cultivate it. That was the first assignment which God gave to man. When you read about this word, work, in the Hebrew, when we say God gave man the Garden of Eden to cultivate it, he was just talking about to work in that garden. It was about work. So tonight I'd like to encourage all families to work for our income. Remember, there's a saying in Chichewa, Sika Zakoka Woba Kulawa. It simply suggests one should work in order to get money or to survive. So tonight let me discourage the spirit of miracle money. That spirit needs to be discouraged. But if we want to get money, we need to work. Not that money will just come as a miracle. That will not happen. So we want to be reminded that there can be no any success without work. If we want to be successful people, successful families, if we want to succeed in life, we need to work. In order for you to be a successful family, you must work. No asset can bring profit if it is not put to work. We need to work. There are some people who are still believing that if they can pray, if they are committed to prayer, they are going to find some money. They would like to substitute work with prayer. But I wanted to make an emphasis tonight that prayer is not and has never been a substitute for work. Whether it's hard or smart work, work should take place. We need to work. We cannot say, I am praying, God is going to do something without work. That will not happen. We need to be reminded that Jesus Christ is our model. Jesus Christ, when he was here, he said, he demonstrated the value of work, and he said to his disciples, I must work the work of him that has sent me. Jesus Christ demonstrated the importance of work, and he said, my Father is working until now, and I myself, I am working. He was working, he was copying from his Father. So let me encourage the house tonight that we need to work. We cannot substitute work with prayer. Whether believer or non-believer, no one is exempted from work. We should work. This thing of miracles, there are some, after praying, they relax and wait for the windows of heaven to shower blessings. That is not a good way to go. We should pray. Prayer is very, very important, but it cannot substitute the work. It doesn't work that way. We need to work and to pray. Even when manna was falling from heaven, it did not fall in their houses. They had to go and collect. That was working. Some people have taken prayer as something to make them lazy. It is very unfortunate. We need to pray, but it does not mean that when we are praying, things will just be happening without action. We need to work, we need to pray, and at the same time, we should also be reminded that working is very, very important. Work culture. In our culture, especially here in Africa, Africa has many traditions and cultures. Africa has cultural food, cultural dress, cultural songs, cultural dances, cultural marriages, but where is the culture of work? That's the challenge. Let me encourage families tonight to develop the culture of work. We need to work. Things cannot just happen without us putting effort. We need to put effort for things to happen. We have said that we need to work so that we can raise income. But I want to remind members tonight that unacceptable ways of getting wealth. Number one, we should not cheat. The Bible records God's strong displeasure on the issues of cheating. The case of Ananias and his wife. They were cheating. They were dishonest. And because of that, God was not happy with them. People like this young man, he was cheating. And according to the book of Proverbs, God is not happy with the scales which are dishonest. This God, the Lord is not happy. Another issue which we can discourage the house is the issue of murder. For this, some people like this gentleman, Naboth. He was murdered. The reason behind, for the one who killed him, he wanted to get wealth. We need to discourage that spirit. we cannot get money through that method of killing someone so that we can get money. That is not the way to take. So this gentleman was killed because the one who wanted to have money from his garden, he decided to kill him so that he can get wealth. This issue of finances, we need to know that God can bless us, but there's this issue how we can manage our personal finances. When God has blessed us, we should also know how to manage whatever we have been given by our Heavenly Father. Poor management of finances can easily affect our families now and even after death. Our families can be affected. If we cannot manage well our finances, it can lead you into stealing and cheating. It can also damage our relationship with our spouses. It can also give stress that can cause health problems because we are not honest on our finances. There is this issue of saving. When we have money, God has blessed us, we should always remember there is tomorrow. This food should be held in reserve for the country to be used during the 7 years of famine. This was the word which came from God. It was advice that God gave to his manservant so that he can instruct the people in Egypt that they should prepare to reserve some food so that in the 7 years to come, people will survive. Here, the reason for saving was to prepare for the years of famine. Let's save something for our emergencies. When the Lord has blessed us, don't start fighting because you have plenty. According to the Bible, Genesis chapter 13, from verse 6 to 8, Abraham and Lot did not agree on some issues because God blessed them. They had plenty. So I would like to encourage you, my dear ladies and gentlemen, when God has blessed us, we should not fight. Let's remind each other that let us not fight. We are a family. People can easily lose focus because God has blessed them. They can easily lose focus and start fighting because the Lord has given them something which they were waiting for and God has responded, but now they cannot agree on how they can manage that finances. Respect each other even when you are blessed. I would like to make a special appeal to our dear women here. This story is a wonderful story. 2 Kings chapter 4 from verse 8 to 10. This lady was blessed, but she did not even forget that she was married. She was able to respect her husband. There are so many ladies, when they are blessed, they do not give any respect to their men. So I would like to encourage you, remember you are married, and God has blessed you, don't forget to respect your man, because you are a family. Remember, whatever you have, that thing has been given to you by God. Don't spend whatever you have been given carelessly. Sometimes we can be given, we can be blessed, but the way we use it carelessly, and we spend it carelessly, and God is not happy on the way we spend some of our things. We should also be reminded on this issue, when we have money, sometimes we are tempted to go into debt. The rich rule over the poor, and the borrower is a slave to the lender. We should learn to control the way we think, or our wish, or our plans. We should learn to control them, because we sometimes are tempted to borrow money, maybe borrowing for unnecessary things. But we should be reminded that the poor, the one who is borrowing, is a slave to the one who has given him that money. Women, please run away from the bad habits of borrowing. Men, please, let's avoid debt. Because in this chapter, 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 1 to 7, the gentleman who borrowed died. Unfortunately, he died before he squared his debt, and the family was in problem, because he contributed to that challenge, and he died leaving his family in a great problem. The issue of finances, we should always remember, if we want to budget, to manage well, we need to budget our finances. One way of coming out of debt is to plan for our finances. How can we plan? We need to have a budget. Whatever we are doing, we should be guided by the budget. If we cannot budget, it is very easy for us to spend carelessly. When we are going for shopping, make a budget list. Don't be controlled by items which you are going to find in the shop, but you should be controlled by the budget. Your list should control you, so that you can apply some plans. I encourage families to sit down and make family budget together. In your budget meeting, first of all, remember to put aside tithe, because tithe belongs to God. That is not our money. We need to set aside tithe, because tithe belongs to God. After tithing, we should also remember to pay our bills. We should also remember to buy food for the family. We have children, we need to feed them. It is our responsibility to take care of our children. So all those things should be put into consideration. And then we should also think of the urgent needs of your spouse. It can be your wife has some needs, urgent one, attend to those needs. It can be your husband, he has some needs, attend to those needs. If she has some needs, attend to her. If he has some needs, attend to those needs, so that he can also be satisfied the way you have discussed your budget. Preparing for retirement. We should all know that we are going to retire one of these days. So I would like to encourage you to plan for your future. remember that you one day retire. That we should always remember. Now my question is, do you have a house or do you have a car? This is a very, very important question for you to think. Do you have a house? Do you have a car? There are some individuals, there are some families, their priority is to have a car. They have a car, but they have no house. They have no even a plot so that they can start building their house for their retirement. So tonight, humbly, I would like to ask those who have cars, and they took this one as their priority, but they have no any piece of land or a house, I would like to appeal to them, please go and sell that car so that you should buy something, a piece of land, so that you can start preparing for a retirement. I would like to make a special appeal to our dear ladies who are here. Sometimes it's you who would like to have a car, and you are encouraging your husband, why can't we buy a car? Why can't we buy a car? I would like to encourage you, please go and tell your husband, why can't we sell a car so that we should buy a plot? You need to have a plot because one day you are going to retire. I want to remind you, some of you, the house which you are, it's not yours. It is for your organization. Where you are working, the institution where you are working has given you that house. So that is not your house. Start planning to have your own house. It is very unfortunate that those who are on higher positions, their policies, working policies, they do allow them to be given a house. But someone, their junior, the policy does not allow him. The good news, those juniors who are not allowed to have an organization house, they have their own houses. But you don't have a house. Please, go and sell a car. You should buy a plot and start something. You can mold bricks this year, and next year you will start with a foundation. The other year you will start raising the wall and you roof the house. Please, don't make a car as your priority. We have several ways of transport. You can go for someone with the Kabaza. Do we have Kabaza here? He can come and drop you to your office. Sell that car and buy a plot. You should start building a house. Maybe we can just assume that at least each and everyone here, we have a plot. But I have seen that almost each and everyone here, you are driving. This is what I have noted. The car park there is full. And to the point that some of you have parked there at Adra. This is very good. But my fear is, do you have a plot? So I would like to encourage you, my dear women gathered here, take this thing seriously. Go and talk to him. Don't forget, those that other day we were saying that we have the majority of singles are our dear women who are widows. So I would like to encourage you, ladies, go and encourage your man to have a plot. You should buy a plot, sell that car, and have a plot, and start preparing for your retirement. We will discuss that one on Sabbath afternoon. Bring it up so that we can discuss and find solutions on that issue. As we are making our budget, we should not forget the needs for our children. School fees, we need to dress them. This is very, very important. Don't be like Isaac and Jacob. You remember these gentlemen. I was listening in the radio. This gentleman, Isaac, went to visit his friend Jacob. And he happened to see that Jacob was blessed with about 10 children. So Isaac was asking him, "My brother, how do you manage these 10 children? How do you manage? How do you feed them?" And his friend responded, "That is not an issue. I just opened the door and let them go. They will see what they will eat." We should not be like that. We need to prepare food for our children. It is our responsibility. We need to prepare school fees for them. That's our responsibility. As we are making our budget, we should also remember other family members, like employees, extended family members. We need to remember them. We should know that this one, the one we have employed, this one needs to be given his salary, her salary, as we made our agreement during the time we were hiring him or her. Do not compensate his or her salary or exchange it with a dress or trouser. Give him money. You did not agree that during your month end you will be given a dress. Give her money. She will make her own budget and she will buy whatever she wants to buy. Don't pay her. You should pay him. He is old enough. He is able to make his budget. Don't make a budget for him. We should also remember to help those who are needed people. We have people who are needed. We are blessed so that we can be a channel to bless other people. Please sit down together and make your budget. Humans are made to work. If anyone will not work, let him not eat. We need to work. We learn that human beings were made in God's image and were designed to reflect his character and behavior. Now, since God is a working God, human beings are to be working people. We are discouraging the spirit of laziness in this church tonight. We need to work because God is a God of work. So if we cannot work, then it will not be possible for each one of us to succeed. Tonight, I want to make a suggestion. Not a suggestion, but I just want to remind you, keep on sending your questions in that box, because we are going to have time to answer to those questions, to respond to those questions. If you have other issues which you want to raise, please put them in the box. If we happen not to find them tomorrow, it will simply suggest that you don't have any question. and we are going to change our plan for Sabbath afternoon. I would like to thank you that you came, and I would like to encourage you that you should also come tomorrow. I know this, the topic for today, is a painful one, because I have encouraged you to go and sell your car, so you are feeling pain. But sorry, this is the truth of the matter. If you cannot take it now, you will take it, but it will be too late. So, my dear ladies and gentlemen, please, let at least find something so that at least we can say, I have a place, I can do something for my retirement. God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor Kuyama, for the insights and reminders on family finance issues. In closing, let's all rise up as we sing our theme song again, the first stanza and the chorus. After that, the pastor will open the petition. May the church rise.
Our meetings. This is our prayer in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.